So finally, I got my hands on the Nothing Phone 1 here in Malaysia, and after watching the very unique global launch, I knew that this phone was going to be something totally different. So besides the whole Glyph Lighting interface, what else is great about this phone? Or is this just hype? Well, let's find out. So I've already unboxed the black color version of the phone on my IG Reels, so you can check that out over there. So in this video, I'll be going through the unboxing for the white color variant, where firstly the box comes in white, then there's the Nothing logo on the top left, the text Phone 1 in the middle, then the visuals of the wireless charging coil back portion of the phone, then there's the model number over at the bottom right. At the back of the box is where you'll find the specs that you choose and the other info like being designed in London by Nothing Technology. Then you'll find a red color tab towards the top right, which you can tear it accordingly. And what's interesting and nice is how there's a sort of a padding on the cover, which is probably to protect the phone from impact during shipping or transport. Then towards the top right again, there's a little tab where there's a smaller white box, where in there is hands down the most unique SIM ejector pin. Next, there is the USB-C to USB-C cable and the manuals as well. Then towards the bottom right, there'll be another pull tab which will reveal the phone over there. Next, looking at the phone's design and build quality, yes, I'm not gonna lie, and yes, as many reviewers have mentioned that it does look and feel like the iPhone 12 lineup onwards with the squarish design and a squared matte finish aluminium frame. However, the phone was very light at 193.5 grams, which I've said before that I've always appreciated and loved phones below the 200 grams mark. As the phone did grip very well, even with its Gorilla Glass finish at the back and also in the front. Now, speaking of the finishes, it is available in two colors, which is in black and also in white. And thank God there was no fancy names for this white and black color. And I think I don't have to tell you which is my favorite color, right? But the differentiating factor is the fact that the black color version will definitely collect more smudges and fingerprints compared to how it's almost not seen at all in the white color variant. Now, I also felt like I could see the texture and the design for the rear way more prominent on the white color variant, especially with the Nothing logo text over there. Hence, you would guess that is indeed my preferred color. Now, speaking of the texture, here's where I'm going to be talking about the rear a little more, as this illuminated Glyph interface is truly something very unique. So there are about 900 plus diffuse LEDs at the back of the phone. Now this is to serve many purposes, as Nothing wanted you to have a new way to communicate with the phone by just glancing at it. Now how this works is that you can get it to signal you for notification, for phone calls, checking the battery status, or even trigger the silent mode by just flipping the phone face down with the Glyph interface facing up when you get a call. Now for phone calls, you can assign contacts to certain ringtones and patterns to know exactly who is calling. Then for notifications, you can choose a different Glyph interface for emails or messages. And when you're charging the phone or even reverse wireless charging the phone is where you can see a lighting indication. Next, if you call out Google Assistant, it will also light up accordingly to your voice as well. Then finally, this Glyph interface lighting could also be used to illuminate close-up subjects when you're taking a photo, as opposed to using the harsh lighting on the flash instead. And I did also notice that the white color variant bounced off the Glyph lights better since it had a white finish. And it's also cool that you can also adjust the brightness over there too, where there is a dedicated Glyph interface menu that also allows you to change the ringtones over there, as mentioned earlier. Now moving on, as for the ports and buttons, looking below, other than the USB-C port, there is one of the two stereo speakers over there, where the second speaker is at the earpiece area, and you'll find a dual SIM card slot. On the left, there is the volume rockers, and on the right, there's the power and the lock screen button. So with the IP53 rating too, I would give this phone's design and build an A+. Because of how extremely unique this is, whether or not you choose the black or the white color, I am sure you will not be disappointed. So the phone's display was surely one of the standout features too, as it comes with a 6.55 inch flexible OLED display with a resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels and up to 1200 nits of peak brightness. Now at first I was a bit curious on why it was called a flexible OLED since it is not a foldable smartphone. And then, Mr. Carl Pei mentioned during the global keynote that in order to make the bezels on the phone symmetrical without having a chin like how other Android smartphones have, they needed to use a flexible OLED panel in order to stretch the screen more towards the bottom edge. And that will give an overall uniformity to the bezels, which in return does make the phone more expensive to produce. So kudos to Nothing on making that move, and talk about attention to details. Nice. Now the display also has a 120Hz refresh rate with 240Hz of touch sampling rate, so the overall experience for scrolling and multitasking was nice and fluid. And with the HDR10+, watching Disney Plus Hotstar and some videos on YouTube was such a great experience as expected, with its 10-bit color depth and also because of the hole punch being at the top left. Now the screen was also flat with once again the Corning Gorilla Glass protection, and here's where I would give the screen an A because it is the second biggest strength during my first impressions. Next, onto the phone's cameras. The Nothing Phone 1 comes with a main 50-megapixel Sony IMX766 sensor with an aperture value of f1.88, which is using a 24mm wide lens with both OIS and EIS image stabilization. Then there's another 50-megapixel camera, which is using Samsung's JN1 sensor. And based on my previous test using that particular sensor, it is one of the best ultra-wide sensors that never has barrel distortion. So it was nice that it is present over here, where it had an aperture value of f2.2. So yes, my friends, it is just two lenses, and thank God for that, as there's no dedicated macro lens, dedicated depth sensor, dedicated black and white sensor, and dedicated grandfather's lens just for the sake of having 25 lenses on the phone. Then the front camera is a 16-megapixel f2.45 aperture, which uses Sony's IMX 471 sensor. Now, based on my test, instead of only taking some quick test shots during the day, as yes, it did turn out great, as you guys can see, but I also decided to take some low-light shots, especially using the Glyph Lighting, and yes, the extra light did help a lot, as seen in these shots, and also thanks to the OIS as well. Now, as usual, I won't rate the camera just yet, as I'm planning to test out the cameras further during my full video review, so subscribe to Adam Lobo TV if you haven't done so. Then as for video recording, the rear camera can record up to 4K 30 frames per second, and the front can record up to 1080p up to 60 frames per second. Now as for the other specs, the Nothing Phone 1 comes with the Snapdragon 778G Plus 5G chipset, which is based on a 6nm process. And this particular variant is the 8GB of RAM with 256GB of UFS 3.1 storage. Then another huge plus, not one plus, is Nothing's very own Nothing OS, where as of the recording of this video, it was at version 1.0.1, which is on top of Android 12. Now here's where there are two things that I already love about it. Firstly, if you're familiar with the Oxygen OS of the yesteryears before OnePlus and Oppo has joined forces, then like me, you will love this menu system. And secondly, there's no other smartphones out right now, especially from an Android's perspective, which has the amount of less bloatware. Because not only the home screen defaults at just one page, but the app drawer is also defaulted in a single page. So yes, with this, I predict that I'll be totally embracing this Nothing OS, but let's see how it is when I use it daily too. And I can say that during my first impressions, I had no issues going from one app to the other, and I was effortlessly blazing through the phone. And also worth mentioning is the fact that the haptic feedback on the phone was very good too. Now in terms of the battery, it has 4,500 mAh of battery with support of 33 watts of wired charging, which will get you about 0 to 50% of battery in about 30 minutes. And then there's also 15 watts of Qi wireless charging and 5 watts of reverse wireless charging. But of course, let's see how much of a battery life that I get when I use the phone daily. Then finally, looking at the phone's pricing and availability, it starts at RM2,399 for the 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage variant, where it will be available at Crossover Online and in-stores here in Malaysia from the 18th of July onwards, which I'll leave all the info down below. Then you can also pre-order it at the Star Hill pop-up store from the 21st of July onwards, and the open sales will be available from the 1st of August onwards, which I also put that info in the description below as well. So in a world where a $1,000 smartphone is considered a normal thing, it is refreshing to see a mid-tier phone with so much attention to detail and of course, prioritizing on the experience more than anything else. And with this, Do let me know what you would like to know specifically about this new Nothing Phone 1 in the comment section below, and of course, I'll revert back during my full video review.